And finally, the issue we want to consider is, what if we broadcast a stale result? Let's see what a stale result is. Okay, so what we have here is a situation when this divide here is going to broadcast its result. It's going to broadcast that it's a reservation station 4 and broadcasting this result, which is the result of the division between these two numbers. But if you look closely at the RAT, none of the registers is currently renamed to this instruction. So how can this happen? Well, one way of it happening is that when this instruction was renamed, let's say that F4 was renamed to be this result. So for a while, this was saying RS4. But then another instruction came, let's say RS2, this subtract. And let's say that it was taking R4 and this and writing again to the register 4. In that case, this would not say RS2. So simply, this instruction no longer has any of the RAT pointing to it. So what's going to happen when we broadcast this result? What's going to happen is, for the filling the reservation stations, it's going to be done normally, pretty much. Every entry for every instruction is going to be matched against the tag here, and wherever we match the tag, we're going to replace it with the value. So in this case, we're going to write, instead of this RS4 here, we're going to get -0.11. Okay, that's the only match, so we are done. The question is, what happens with the register file and the RAT? In that case, in the RAT, we do nothing. Why? Well, because the value from this instruction will never be used by any of the instructions that come later. The only reason why we needed the values in the register file is that after this broadcast happens, all the instructions that need that value are going to get it from the register file, so the value had better been there. Also, all the instructions that come in after this instruction are going to look here to see what is the newest renamed value of this result. And they're going to find RS2, for example, for this value. However, if this is RS4 and this is RS2, that means that there is a new instruction that is producing the value for this register. So basically, after this instruction here has been renamed, all the instructions that come and read F4 should actually get the new value from this. So this is basically the situation. We had a divide come first. For a while, everything that reads F4 should be getting the value from the divide. After the add here has renamed F4 to point to it, all the instructions that come after that are supposed to use this value when they read R4. So this is entirely correct behavior. So pretty much what we're doing is, when we broadcast this and capture it here, we're giving it to any of the instructions that sit between this divide and this add that are actually using this result. But because the add has already been renamed, the instructions that we are renaming now and that we are getting results from the register file, those instructions actually need the value from the add, so they really don't need anything from this divide. So pretty much, if the tag that is being broadcast doesn't match any of the entries in the RAT, then we don't update the RAT, and we don't update the register file, and it is perfectly fine, because all of the instructions that possibly need this value are already in reservation stations. When you do quizzes and so on, be careful about this, because it is so easy to, kind of just make the entry here point to the register file. For example, here, it would be incorrect to delete this because it doesn't match this.